And next, we will be learning more about the IBM and SAP partnership for digital transformation. Our speaker is Mr. Anshu Dubey, Executive Director for Global Business Services, IBM India and South Asia. So if I could tell the audience a little about you, of course, it's all there in a nutshell. But he has over 22 years of management and IT consulting experience across organizations like PwC, Accenture, and IBM. He has worked on assignments for a variety of industries across retail, consumer products, manufacturing, pharmaceuticals, and service. So without further ado, we give you Mr. Dubey.
Thank you. So before I begin, really appreciate the audience and the opportunity about the event to IBM. Just a point, we have since morning, I've realized that we have traversed through what's happening on the ground, case studies or war stories that we have heard from clients which have gone in the implementation journey, and the kind of art of possible. What I am taking today is not talk about products or, but similarly taking on some of the proof of concepts that we are kind of working together with SAP, and some of the things that you might ignite your and you can take back to your organization to see where it has transcended to. So it is basically the partnership that has forged with IBM and SAP, right? It's two big organizations identified that what should be the organization of tomorrow, right? So the client is common. We needed organizations which are smart. They need data to be smart, right? Your processes to be imbibed across geographies. People should be enabled. So if you look at it from a outside-in perspective, the journey is something that we have all been trying to live as we've gone around the ERP journey and the whole digital story that we are hearing today. What happens at the inside-out view is we look at things like cognitive, we look at cloud, we look at design thinking and design thinking application to simplify some of these things, to enable the end consumer, which are the various roles within the organization which use these applications and these data points to deliver the value that the stakeholders demand. Why a partnership of SAP? It's a joint mission. It is about the capability of possible. So if you look at SAP's industry value engineering, as well as the IBM business value, coming together and thinking and identifying what are the key components or points that we can drive the whole user experience to and take it to a level which can deliver value to the customer. So what we did was we invested in about 40 resources on IBM and SAP. We had them hosted down at Palo Alto and Waldorf, coming together, sitting together. And we identified, put in some money, about $1 million on these few assets that we are building on. And these assets that plan to take forward to commercial use. So at this point in time, some of these POCs are done with customers, our skin in the game. But as we go, these will be commercial products and things can be taken forward from there. If you look at the solution, we talked about digital core is where the SAP core HANA sits, right? But if you look at, you have Fury, you have Hybris, you have all these new generation products which SAP has acquired, inculcated, intertwined, and you have the design thinking application and design capability of IBM, which has now started to translate some of these solutions into reality. So it is across customer, it's around workforce, which is more internal, based on success factors. If you look at IoT of things, that's something that has been driven from the area where we have seen limited investments and focus from a manufacturing standpoint. And what it has done, brought up a whole lot of value roadmaps from a customer and unearthed value. So if you look at the size of the problem today, right? People have started talking about, as I think one of the earlier speakers mentioned, we have stopped talking about investments. We have stopped talking about cost, right? It has been those era which has gone, and it's talk about simplification, usability, penetration, growth. And that is where the focus is. So if you look at it, if you used to at some point in time go across and drive a ERP implementation, it used to have this typical ascendant methodology. You would go through those motions. You would look at data as one of the critical aspects that you, training would be a decent testing. Gone are the days now where we are starting to call it differently. You talk about Ascend, you talk about Apple partnerships, you talk about design being applied. So the blueprint phase is now broken into design thinking workshops where people are thinking out of the box and demanding of SIs like us and products like SAP to be in a state where it can actually deliver and the realization that some of these outcomes are sought for. So here are those 8 proof of concepts. These are to be launched at Sapphire next week. I thought it would be a good platform to showcase some of these at this point in time so that you are aware of what is happening around the world. And some of it, I think, in bits and pieces, you might have tried and tested in your own organization or things that you can take back home. So this is the case where recruiter, right? All this while you would have a SAP HR system, HRMS system. Now you have SuccessFactors. But what SuccessFactors helps you with is a database, a processes which is laid out, and you go through those motions. Where Cognitive helps us do is it helps predict and pick out the right candidate for you, right? What it does, it looks at the portfolio that you've received of those CVs, both internal and external, based on the various external media and data points that you have. It prompts you for interaction and interfaces that you need to do with those candidates, and the HR recruiter is able to pinpoint, prioritize who they should focus on, and then recommend the kind of candidates one should go for. The next is the e-commerce. A typical brick and mortar organization entering into the e-commerce arena. We've talked about omni-channel, but how do you drive traffic from a brick and mortar and take it to omni-channel space, right? Because there are inherent challenges that humans have, right? Why would somebody walk into a store because you want customized interaction that you have? Those are the challenges. Then if you put some sort of a Watson cognitive and you go down to the site and you press help me, and in easy natural languages interact with, and Watson directs you and addresses steps like what happens to my old handset, what happens to my data, how am I able to take back my messages, my contact should not get lost, what is the difference between a single SIM, dual SIM, and all those things which you find at least at a loss when you are in a e-commerce arena. You are supposed to be gifted. You typically, what you tend to do is get your answers from a brick and mortar and go and procure it for a better margin on online. This is something that has started to see some traction there. IoT for stability. Again, a lot of organizations over the period have invested in decent machines where you get fair bit of data. People frankly do not know what to do with that data. This is one area which has been talked about much, fairly limited penetration if you look at what's happened on the ground. Over the last couple of years, needle has moved on this, but I think still some way to go. Here also, taking the data out, applying it, and getting some sort of a sustainability mechanism. Claims, again, I think this is the insurance. How do claim adjustments get addressed? What are the kind of information that you can enable the field staff with? It's not something that you need to take back, bring it back to office, fill it up, have queries, go. You are empowering the person on the ground with a tablet. This is the IBM plus Apple joint partnership which has enabled, and I think some of you would have heard about the SAP-Apple partnership as well, I think, which had got announced last couple of days. But this is something that is clearly happening in terms of enabling, and we are seeing some of this getting reflected in an absolutely different use case at Kalyan Jewelers in India as well, where you are enabling things on tablet, you are giving them, prompting them with questions that should be asked, which helps, and based on the data about the profile and the of the particular user, you are able to predict whether some of these elements are first time right and eliminate the chance of rerun. Postfix is something which is more in terms of electronics, addressal of white goods servicing, right? So people do not know, people are not equipped. It helps you basically on a tablet, takes you through those motions about how one should execute it on the field. You have back-end integrity with SAP. It provides you what kind of spares and call out that are required for a particular beat that you need to go to and fulfills you rather than going back and forth. And ultimately, a better customer experience. Predictive maintenance, I think I heard today at Asian Paints something being done about it. This is around similar. The impact of predictive maintenance, if you go about it, it acts on your supply chain, it acts on your production, and it prompts you in terms of what alternate machines or trucks in this case can be addressed so that it has minimum impact in your delivery cycle. So smart